Well, Scott, the low rumble or loud rumble you hear at this point is Keyspan Energy trying to shut off the gas to this structure. The pictures really speak for themselves here. You can see it caved in about 1 a.m. this morning with a kind of domino effect pattern. Fire officials say one truss section went down and the rest quickly followed. A number of boats are stored inside, but it's still too soon to tell which ones will be back on the lake and which ones are destroyed.
Pushing weight of wet snow and ice claims yet another building. But the owners of Irwin Marine and Laconia say this collapse has them baffled.
We had actually rehabbed that building when we purchased it a few years ago and felt it was in very good shape.
With the structure a total loss, attention now turns to what's inside. Boats, 15 to 20 of them, averaging 20 to 25 feet in length. How many are damaged and whether or not they're salvageable remains a mystery. But no one is encouraged by the wreckage.
We're going to work with the insurance and get a crew in here and try to minimize additional damage to the boats as we get them out of the building.
With much of the lakes region stressed by heavy snowfall, homeowners are clearing off what they can before the next big storm.
We have been working for 2 weeks trying to keep up with the snow. And we did have a building have a little beam bust inside, so we're a little worried too.
The Laconia Fire Department is issuing a warning about heavy snow loads coming up at 6. Hear from the fire chief about why this snow is so heavy. Reporting live in Laconia, Adam Sexton, WMUR News 9.